What the difference that you see in ministry today with young people today, how can they be more effective? How can they be more effective in ministry? Can they sit back and watch us do it, or can they push beyond? Because you're unusual. I have never seen a young girl like you, your age, just on fire for God.
It started early, but of course we have different issues and circumstances in our lives that God will allow to push us. You know, mm-hmm. He uses those things to help us, and sometimes we can either draw closer to Him or we can shrink back. And by the grace of God and the work of the Holy Spirit, He just pulled me in a little bit closer, and it wasn't always because I desired
that.
Give
me those points right there where how can young people can get involved more so.
Right, they get involved, number one, by being in the Word.
Okay.
And I have to start there because that's how we learn who God is. That's His love letter to us. That's everything about His character and His nature. And the more we are invested in the Word, we get the Word into us, and then we begin to hear His voice more clearly. So it's getting in the Word of God, then understanding how to discern the voice of God so that we can follow the will of God, so we can do the will of God. I think that a lot of times we're not exposed to things, and a lot of times individuals, young people in particular, think church is this one box, this one, like, traditional thing, whatever your tradition may be. But I think God is moving in so many ways outside of those boxes that we have to avail ourselves to the opportunity to learn and to grow in those ways. So you get involved not only in church, but you see the church in community, because church isn't the building. We are the people of God in the world. Being salt and light will give you that edge. And so whether you're on your school campus, whether it's a high school, middle school, college, university, wherever you are, there's an opportunity for you to join with others and develop this prayer life, develop this discipline of being in the Word so that you can live it out. And then I believe God starts to bring opportunities in front of you. He starts to direct your path and order your steps so that everything He invests in you, you can then share with the world. And before you know it, I mean, there's just this new path and this new way you probably never even imagined, but it's an adventure that you wouldn't trade for a lifetime.
Mm-hmm. Is this for you, for women, or for young men too?
Oh, absolutely, it's for everybody. This walk, now I know you're saying that, you're asking that based on her call ministries and things mm-hmm. like that, but my passion has been for anybody who's willing to hear the mm-hmm. word of God. Mm-hmm. I'm actually the oldest of three children, and have two younger brothers, so I've always had a heart that young men would grow because I lived with them. And then I've had great friends who are in encouragement to me. I used to call them in my younger days my men's ministry because they were really sweet young men who had a godly, protective covering for me. And it was a beautiful thing to grow up in those types of healthy relationships. Mm-hmm. And I regret nowadays it's hard to find that, but I believe we can get back to it when we learn how to walk in line with the Word of God and enjoy the life He's given us. So I think it's for everybody.
Now, are you married?
No, I'm not.
You're not married. Okay, so how can a young girl like you get married? Because that's the question they all come up to me and ask me. How can you get married? How can who do you find, and all that kind of stuff?
I really like the scripture where it says that the man that findeth a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. Mm-hmm. And then I go back to Genesis and I look at how God brought Eve to Adam when he was asleep. Mm-hmm. I think as we are totally invested in God's will, He brings along into our lives, into our paths, those that we are to connect with, and not only for work of the ministry, but for life, relationship, and ultimate covenant.
Yeah.
So I believe as we pursue the Lord, and we of course stay open, you know, to your options, look around, you see what's there, but don't ever compromise who you are.
Mm-hmm.
Just to get a ring.
Okay.
And that's for men as well. I know some men who say, you know, I'd love to have a godly wife, but we have to really rest in the Lord and trust that He's going to do what He's going to do in His appointed time.
Okay, so how do you balance what you're saying right here, the Word of God and all these wonderful things, and the reality of reality TV shows and the reality of luring and pulling people in? How do you balance that?
Well, the bottom line is we have to take everything back to the standard of the Lord, which is, again, is expressed in the Word of God. And I believe that entertainment and all those things, they have their place. But when we look for investing in our lives so that we can be all that God wants us to be, we have to really take a look. Are these shows, are the program and the music and all of that, is it helping me to grow in Christ and to be more hidden in Him? Is it fueling my spirit for serving Him? Or is it kind of taking me away and giving me some images and ideas?
Good.
that aren't good for me.
That's good. Say that again.
Okay. Are those things, we have to measure it by the word, the standard of the word. So the more we're in the word, it helps us to see, and you can kind of start watching television and listening to music and say, well, this isn't lining up with what God says. So is this going to build me up, or is it kind of detracting me and taking me away from God's will? Mm-hmm. And ultimately, everything is doing one or the other. It's building your spirit up. It's helping you to see God more clearly, or in some way, it's showing you the way of the world system and the world mindset, and then you'll have to go back and really kind of reprogram your mind, get that out of there, and start focusing on what God says. And it's not to say we can't have fun, because I believe the Christian life, when it really is totally devoted to the Lord, it is an adventure. It is a wonderful adventure. We have our ups and downs, but I know because of what I've lived through, and even at a young age, I know from what I've lived through and what I'm going through right now, I wouldn't trade it for the world. He's brought me through so much, even in 2010. I mean, that's a whole nother show. Yeah. But even in that, as I look back, I thank God for every situation that even brought pressure to my life, because it pressed me into His presence.
Yes.
And I wouldn't trade that for anything.
And then with you having a good support system, mm-hmm. a mom and dad, mm-hmm. and your brothers and sisters, that has a whole lot to do with it too, right?
It does.
It's so that you can stay on focus and grounded.